Hey, Ross here from Search and Filter. Today is a very exciting day. After years of working on version 3, I'm finally ready to share with you the beta of the Pro plugin. In today's video, I'm going to show you a few key new features: the autocomplete field, the current selection field, dynamic search with Ajax, the load more button, and tons of design options. Let's get to it. So first things first, let's create a quick page using the query loop. Don't worry if you're not using the block editor. We do have other integration options, but for today's video, I'll be mainly focusing on the block editor. Let's choose, I like this one. We'll just tidy it up a bit. There we go. And one thing to make sure, actually, whenever you use a query loop, is to make sure that we uncheck this setting, inherit query from template. By default, it's on. And if we view the page, we've got our list of posts there. So I'm gonna get stuck in now and I'll probably whiz through a few things. What I'll do now is I'll add an autocomplete field to this page and I'll link it with the query loop. And once we've got that working, we'll build out a couple of extra things on top of that. So the autocomplete field is a type of search field. So we'll add the search block, search field block. The first thing to do is to connect this field to the query loop block, and we can do that with a query integration. And I'm going to whiz through these options, but essentially we want to configure this to work on a single page. And we want it to be the current page. And we've already set that it will be the query loop block. And we're going to auto detect the query loop. One other thing that I'll do is I'll just change the post type. We have a people post type that I want to search today. So we'll just select that and remove the other one. And we can update that. Now we have the field connected to the query loop. I'm going to go ahead and configure the data type for our suggestions and some of the other general settings and just get this field looking a bit better. So we'll get our suggestions from a taxonomy for this post type called favorite colors. We'll update the URL name to colors. And then we'll swap the input type from text to autocomplete. Because it's an autocomplete field, I'm actually going to disable the auto submit for now. And if we check that, now we should have the autocomplete field working with the query loop. So there we go. These are the people that have the favorite color blue. Let's go back and add a submit button. A submit button is a control field. Control type is set to submit. We'll update the label. We'll sort out that spacing in a moment. I think it would also be good to enable dynamic update. There we go. And let's fix that spacing issue. We can do that by going to the styles tab of the field, and we can add some margin. There we go. The next thing I'm going to do is add a load more button. That's also a control field. And we need to make sure that we don't put it inside the query loop. I'm working on that one at the moment. I'll change the control type to load more. And to get the layout a bit better, I'm going to wrap that in a group, convert the group to a row, and then do central alignment. And there we have the load more button. To show that a bit more clearly, I will edit the post per page setting of the query. So we can say we do 5 posts per page. And seeing as we've got a load more button, we don't actually need the pagination. I think the next thing we'll do is show some of the design options. I think it's better if we add another field to make that a bit more obvious. So let's add a choice field. We'll use another taxonomy, and this time it will be favorite cuisines. We'll add some margin on the field again. And it's connected to the same query. There we go. So we have the autocomplete field and a select field. And these are some cuisines. What you'll notice is auto submit is on. So as soon as we change the field, the results will update. And that setting is just all the way at the bottom here, the behavior field. You can actually change the delay of the auto submit. So certain fields need a little bit longer. You want to give the user a bit more time to make their choices. So let's say if we change it to 500 milliseconds. So there's a slight delay now. We don't really need it on this field. So let's bring that back down. I think it's probably a good idea to dive into some of the design options. So for every field that you add, you have the styles tab. And within the styles tab, you've got quite a lot of settings. Let's start with the colors. So here you can see for this particular field, we can change the color, the background color, the selected color and the background color of that, 3 border colors for different states, the icon color and the clear color. The clear color is just this clear icon here. Let's try to do a dark mode kind of style. And let's play with all of the color options. see how that looks. Okay, and let's update that selection color too. Cool, I like that. And let's do the same again to this field. I'm not going to be too exact today. On this field, we have an interactive color. So different fields have like an interactive element, an additional one. In this case, we have the drop down button. So we can also color that. I think keeping it white is a good idea in this case. Let's save that. There we go. And the last thing to do would be to apply it to the submit button. And this time we'll add on some border colors just to show that working. There we go. There's quite a few other design options here to play with, mostly to do with spacing. So one of the main ones is scale, and that just scales up or down the size of the input field. The cool thing about the scale is if you set the same value of scale between your fields, they'll all be matching in shape and size. So we could enlarge this, and then we can match that one to a scale 4. And the same with the submit button. So that should all be kept in sync. And something else I wanted to show you was the current selection field. That will show you what's been selected currently and enable you to deselect those options. That's also a control field. We'll change the control type to selection. A visible label is not required, but it will be in your markup and it will be available to things like screen readers. So you should always put in a meaningful label. In this case, we'll disable it. Let's customize this field. Scale that up to what we're using over here, 4. We what you'll see now, there we go. We have blue as a favorite color selected. It's detected that and displays it above. And we can disable the selection. There we have a favorite cuisine. As you can see, as we update the cuisines, the selection updates, and then we can deselect that just by pressing it there. One last thing I want to show in this video are the toggleable headings. So it's been on the feature request list forever to get these toggleable headings for all the fields. So I'm just going to show quickly how that works with the favorite colors. If we head on to the label section, we can set the label to toggle the input visibility of the input. And now you'll see it has a little icon there. And if we don't do anything with it, you'll see that it can now show and hide the input field. And we can also style the labels. We especially want to do that now. So here we have some options for labels, label dimensions, and label color. So we might want to make that a bit chunky. And let's add some padding to the label. So there you have it, a super quick run through of some of the new features. If you want to get your hands on the plugin and you're on the mailing list, you already have the link, so you know what to do. If you're not on the mailing list, we'll be sharing the details soon enough. There were a lot of features I didn't get to cover today, but I'm sure I'll cover them in the next videos. And I think it's about time I did a video for non-block editor users too. I hope you're as excited as I am about the new version, but that's all we've got time for today. Thanks for watching.